When a user asks a question to a Rasa assistant running on the Calm Dialog system, how does it know which user journey to activate and when? In this video, we'll explore how the Rasa Dialog system can dynamically initiate user journeys known as flows at just the right moment. Calm will typically activate a new flow in the following scenarios. Number one, at the beginning of a new user journey to react to the initial user input. Number two, in the case that the user switches topics, so imagine that they're in a flow and then want to switch to a topic covered by another flow. Or number three, the flow was linked to from another flow. In this case, the system will just programmatically hop to the flow that you defined in a link node, so no model involvement is required. One of the great things about Calm is that you can opt to activate flows with an LLM, a large language model, or an intent model. The two approaches to dialogue understanding can coexist in the same system. In the next section, I'll talk about how to activate flows with flow descriptions, and then we'll talk about how you can add on a natural language understanding classifier, an NLU classifier, so that both approaches can coexist in the same system. Let's begin with flow activation using an LLM. If you've watched the video How Calm Works, you're already familiar with the importance of dialogue understanding in Rasa's dialog system. In order to support users with their queries, Calm reads incoming user inputs, assesses them in the context of the ongoing conversation, and intelligently selects the most relevant flow based on the flow description. You can edit and manage your flows right from the Studio user interface. Let's do that now. As you can see, we're already in the flows section of Rasa Studio. Since this assistant is already in progress, you can already see here that we have several flows defined. Each flow has a flow name, a flow description, and it also has a toggle button here to indicate whether this flow is ready for training or not. Let's break down these components. Starting with the flow name is the title of the flow. I like to use categorical prefixes or namespaces to better organize my flow. Especially as you scale to have many flows, it can be really helpful to group them logically by topic. For example, all of my flows related to time off start with the word leave, like leave vacation policy or leave booking time off. And similarly, I use the prefix payroll for flows about payday and payslips, and the prefix general for more centralized reusable flows like my authentication flow or my CSAT survey flow. Flow names are pretty straightforward. Let's move on to flow descriptions. The flow description is really essential in the Rasa dialog system, Calm. As covered in How Calm Works, throughout the conversation, if a new flow is necessary to progress the conversation forward, Calm will read the conversation in context and look to identify the most relevant flow based on its description. The language model reads through the available flow descriptions to match the user requests with the next best flow. If no suitable flow is found or the input is off topic, Calm may not activate any flow. Now, if you want to optimize your flow descriptions, I've got a few tips for you. First, you're going to want your description to really focus on the purpose of the flow. You want to clearly state what the flow does. You're also going to want to use active language. Opt for verbs that show action when you're writing your flow descriptions. You're going to want to be consistent. You're going to want to use the same writing style throughout. And you're also going to want to keep it simple. Avoid jargon, any unnecessary details or technical terms. You're also going to want to explain terminology. If you have unique or industry-specific terminology or words, explain what they mean in the flow description. And lastly, an option, you can optionally choose to include examples. Sometimes this can help to give the LLM examples of what users might say, and usually I don't add them in unless the initial very concise description isn't working to my satisfaction. So in practice, imagine you have a flow that, say, lets the user know what day they will be paid that month. So answers user questions about payday. We're going to open up this description. And you can see right here already that the following description we have is really not detailed enough, as there are many payroll questions that one could ask. Let's try and make this a better description. So here I've replaced that description with another description. Tell the user when payroll or paydays are scheduled. Provide information about when the next payroll is and provide the payroll schedule listing upcoming paydays. So this is much more descriptive. It's still concise. It's about three lines. And I've also added one or two synonyms for the topic. So payroll and payday, things like this. Flow descriptions are all about being concise. A best practice is, again, to start with the most concise version that you can think of, then adding more information or examples if really necessary. Now, I'll save that. The last bit that is important for activating flows is the ready for training toggle switch right here. If you have this switched on, then I ultimately tell the system that this flow is ready to be trained and included in my model. So that means if I toggle it on and then I click the train button, then it will be included in training. If it's toggled off as it is now, then it will be excluded from training. This really allows you to keep draft flows separate from the main training set. So you can continue to work on a draft and only switch it on when you're ready for it to be included in training. This helps you collaborate with your colleagues as well so that you don't accidentally add something to the training corpus that isn't yet ready. Since again, this flow isn't yet ready for training, I'm gonna keep it off and we can switch it on later. Now, let's talk about an alternate way of activating a flow. Flows can be activated not only through descriptions, but also through using NLU classifiers. If you're new to NLU, check out our video on intents linked in the description to understand how intents work to direct dialogue. Supporting intents to activate flow allows teams to transition to calm gradually or to continue using existing intents where they're already effective. If you have intents that perform well, there's really no need to change a running system. It can help you reduce costs as an intent doesn't cost an additional call to a language model. So a hybrid approach with flow descriptions and intents can be more cost efficient. Now, if you're wondering how intents can be used to activate the flow if you already have a flow description, within Calm, there's really an order of operations when it comes to activating flows. First, if a new flow should be activated, Calm looks for NLU intents that will serve that user input. If an existing intent can serve the purpose and the user input triggers that intent with high enough confidence, Calm will use the intent and route the user to that flow that it is attached to. In the scenario that there is no intent or the intent is not triggered with a high enough confidence, the LLM will next check for flow descriptions that could serve the user's need. That's why even if you have an intent defined for a specific flow, it's a good practice to have a flow description written down as well so that the system can fall back on the flow description in the scenario that the intent confidence is not high enough. To manage your intents, you can go to the NLU section of the Rasa Studio menu, and here you'll find all the different intents that I've created. Since Calm excels in handling multi-turn dynamic conversations, in this instance, I'll use intents for flows where I know that users tend to give very clear input. Put, for example, when is payday or how much vacation do I have left? These are both types of queries that might make good intent examples for, let's say, a payday intent or a vacation remaining intent. So for better organization at scale, you can see that each intent here is also prefixed with a topic or a namespace. And I keep the same prefixes for topics across intents and flows. So in this case, you can again see the prefix payroll and also leave. This namespacing again just keeps everything organized and manageable. Clicking inside the payroll payday intent, as you can see where I am right now, here's the space where you can really add new intent examples, you can delete intent examples, you can add and delete intents and annotate entities. So it's really a great CMS for managing your NLU primitives. Now, one thing to keep in mind that the success of your NLU model really requires good training data. And so it's important to reflect how your users are actually talking. If you're interested in learning about how to improve the intent model, check the link in the description about conversation-driven development and the process of how to listen to your user in order to improve your AI assistant's performance. Now that we have two different ways to activate a flow, we have NLU triggers and we also have LLM descriptions, let's create a small single-turn flow about payroll that can be activated by an LLM or an intent. So we're gonna go back to the very top, we're gonna enter this flow. And again, this is a simple single turn flow. It's basically just a Q&A. And we'll open up the start node here. And you can see I have two different ways of activating this flow. I can keep the calm description here, in which case this flow would only be activated if the LLM was active and chose to activate this flow. Or I can also add an NLU trigger. As you saw, I already had a payroll payday intent, so I could add that as a NLU trigger, and I'm gonna set the confidence quite high. I'm gonna set it at 80%. So in this scenario, it means the system can only activate this flow if it has an intent confidence of 80% or higher. That means the system has to be pretty sure that this is the correct flow in order to use this intent. Now, I'm gonna set this whole flow as ready for training. I'm gonna double check, go back to my NLU panel and make sure that my intent is also ready for training. Great, we'll go back to here. And I'm going to, let's go back to flows, and I'm going to train the model. So Now you should have a pretty good understanding of how Rasa decides to activate certain flows and how important it is to write a good flow description. Follow along in the next video to continue your Rasa Studio learning journey.